I am a Yank in Sussex. But you might ask, what is this place, Sussex, that the Yank is in? Well, let me tell you. First, a little disambiguation is in order. As far as I have been able to discover, there are five places called Sussex in the English-speaking world. They are found on three continents, Australia, North America, and Europe. In Australia, there was formerly a Sussex County in the state of Western Australia, but it's now called the Sussex Land District. It has an approximate population of 51,000. In the United States, there are three. Sussex County in the state of Delaware, with a population of about 230,000. Sussex County in the state of New Jersey, having a population of about 150,000. And Sussex County in the state of Virginia, with 12,000 people. But the Sussex that this Yank is in is the original Sussex, the one all of the other Sussexes are named after, and this is the one in southeast England. This original Sussex is also the largest of them all. It's slightly larger than all of the others combined in land area, and in population with over 1.6 million people, it's more than three times as large as all the others combined. To provide a basic overview, Sussex is a historic county in southeast England. It's bounded by the counties of Hampshire, Surrey, and Kent, and by the English Channel to its south. The county name Sussex originates with the Old English language. Back in the day, it was called Sussex. This name means South Saxons in the same way that East Sussex, meaning East Saxons, is now the name of the county of Essex, and West Sussex, for West Saxons, refers to the obsolete geographic name Wessex. And in case you were wondering after hearing this, it turns out that there was no corresponding Norsex or North Saxons. I am not sure why not, and I don't think anyone else does either. Yeah. So let me show you where metropolitan London is located in relation to Sussex. As you can see, it's a fairly short drive to get to London from Sussex, although you'd be well advised to leave the driving to the Londoners. And take the train into London, Yankee Doodle. Forget the pony. But a feather for your cap, or the macaroni, are completely optional. Sussex local government has been divided since 1888 for many administrative purposes into the ceremonial counties of West Sussex and East Sussex. I tend to ignore this division for the purposes of these videos, but it's sometimes useful, so here's where the border between them is drawn. Geologically, the landforms of Sussex are old, as is all of the British Isles. But this age is especially evident in Sussex's geology, where one can see how millions of years of erosion have shaped the land. Here's a map of southeast England, with Sussex's borders outlined in red. The colors in the map represent different bedrock types. I'm not going to give a detailed explanation of what all these colors represent. This isn't a geology video, after all. But the colors do provide some demarcation of the bedrock underlying the landscape. In this view of southeast England, you can see that, in relation to Sussex, there are three major geological regions. These are, from north to south, the North Downs, the Weald, and the South Downs. Since the word downs might be confusing as used here, since they are actually high ground, I should explain that the word downs comes from a word in Old English, namely dune, meaning hill. Nowadays we use the word dune when it comes to wind-driven sand heaps, so you can see the connection with hill. As for weald, which is also from the Old English, it signifies woodland, and the weald was once covered with forest. The nature of both the North and South Downs is clearly seen in the easternmost extension of the South Downs, the place called Beachy Head, where it overlooks the English Channel. This tall chalk escarpment overlooks the sea here by about 500 feet. One might mistake the cliffs here for the more famous White Cliffs of Dover, but Dover's cliffs are in Kent, and they are the termination of the North Downs. The cliffs at Dover are actually much shorter than these here at Beachy Head. They reach only as high as 350 feet, making them a good 200 feet shorter. Both the Weald and the Downs used to be covered with trees, but by around 3,000 years ago, humans had cut down all the trees on the downs in favor of grasslands, upon which they grazed their cattle, primarily sheep. The Weald itself retained its forest to a degree, but today there is far more cropland than forest. The geography of Sussex is to a large degree dependent upon its geology. No surprise, since this is true of most places on Earth. Sussex has three main geographic subregions, each oriented approximately southeast to northwest. In the southwest of the county is the fertile and densely populated coastal plain. North of this are the rolling chalk hills of the South Downs, beyond which is the well-wooded Sussex Weald. Have you ever heard that famous song, Jerusalem, with words from William Blake's epic poem, Milton, A Poem in Two Books? The song has been described as England's unofficial national anthem. Naturally, God Save the Queen is the official one. The last line of the song, Jerusalem, as commonly sung, contains this apt description, England's green and pleasant land. One of the best parts of the green and pleasant land is the beauty of the South Downs. This has long been recognized, but only recently in 2011 was the bulk of the downs designated a national park. Of course, it's called the South Downs National Park, and a large portion of it lies within the borders of Sussex. It's rather longer than it is wide, naturally, given the nature of the chalk formation, and stretches for 70 miles from Beachy Head in Sussex to Winchester in Hampshire. In a later video, I'll cover the South Downs National Park in greater detail. There's a lot to know about and see there. This is the end of part one of What is Sussex? Keep a lookout for part two coming up soon. Have a good day. This has been a production of A Yank in Sussex. If you've enjoyed the video, please click the like button. If you haven't already done so, feel free to click the subscribe button, along with the notification bell, in order to be notified when new videos are posted on the channel. May you have a very nice day.